started the process of planning my EVO project. And I decided, instead of going to Town Forest or somewhere else in town, I went to a place that was a big part of my childhood, the Pine Hills Conservation Area. It was a shortcut to school for me and a lot of other people I know. I have some friends who live right on the property, backyards that are in the woods. So I decided I'm going to try to fix up the place, make it more noticeable to the town, kind of bring more people to it. It's part of my EVO project. So the main focus of the project is to bring more people to the area. I've been by it a lot and I haven't seen too many people there. I know there used to be people a lot when I was a kid, but recently there haven't been. So I want to bring more people to the area. I want to put a new sign similar to this one right here at the Maple Street parking area, and Maple Street entrance. The entrance is kind of hidden. Not too many people know about it, but a lot of people walk by it anyway. They just don't know that it's a conservation area. They think it's just some guy's backyard. It does border a driveway. And I've been told that that driveway is the property line, so any of the grass and trees in that area is conservation. The area on Maple Street, it's right near Washington Park. A back entrance there would have a lot of people walking through it, be able to see this sign. And again, it would be similar to this sign on the Pinevale Ave entrance to the parking area. Another thing is the parking area. When doing research for this project and trying to get pictures, I actually drove by it twice, missed it both times, because as you see, it's not really, unless you really look for the sign, you can't really tell what it is. It looks just like a normal little divot where no trees are grown. I want to make this look more like a parking area, invite more people in. This is on a public road, so if people drive by, they will see this. I want to lay down new pea stone because most of what's there has been run over by dirt. A little bit of grass that started growing in it. I looked at the sign earlier and it was back in, I believe it's 1977. It was the last time this place had, or when this place was originally dedicated and created. So I just want to create a new sign at the other entrance, bring this parking lot back to life, make it more welcome. That was the Pinevale area, yes.
Pinevale Ave, yeah.
I do want to make, another thing was make the woods more private, more public, more used by the public. Walking through the woods a few times, I've noticed a lot of overgrown trails, muddy trails, some damage to parts of them. In the storms we had, I believe back in 2012, 2013, two trees had fallen over the path. One of them still blocking it. Looks like somebody tried to chop it down, got halfway through it, and it's still just laying in the center of the trail. There is a lot of trash in the area, unfortunately, and a lot of it, I plan on taking some of the older scouts in the area, some volunteers, and going in there and removing all the trash, because most of it is beer cans, unfortunately. So I would take some of the older scouts, more mature, get that out of there before introducing other volunteers to the area. I do want to take down that fallen tree, remove some of the overgrowth, and clean up the trails in general. Any trail maintenance that I can do, I will try. And finally, if possible, I would do some advertising for the area, maybe a newspaper for Reading Chronicle or some flyers around town and businesses, just to bring more people there, keep some people who are leaving trash in there out, just bring the place back to life, kind of. So.
I hear you about the trash.
trash, because last year some of us went in there and tried to remove some trash.
We got a couple bags.
I got a bag. These folks got a couple bags.
I had some pictures I didn't want to put on here because I know it'd be on RCTV and more people seeing that, but a lot of it is a lot of beer cans. There's one area that I actually tried to get a picture of my phone and died. It was 20 feet by 20 feet, and it was just a pile. It would have been 5 trash bags at least.
Was the entrance at Pinedale Ave?
Did that have a washing machine right there?
Yeah.
And get rid of that?
Dishwasher.
It was a dishwasher.
Dishwasher, yeah.
Why not? Yeah, right. Great place for it.
Sure. How do you fund getting the sign?
So I haven't put a lot of research into it, but the sign itself, I've looked at others in the area and on conservation trails. It looks like it's just 2 pieces of 4x4 or 6x6 as a main post, and then I think it was 2x10s. So 2x4s or 4x4s or 6x6 right there, and then 2x10s or 2x8s along it, and those are either painted or engraved and painted to show what it is. And either I can do that myself, or if the town says that it has to be done by somebody else, I go out and have them do it. In terms of fundraising, I've been told there have been a lot of donations for the peace stone. I've been told that will be donated. And I plan on going around the area to people who live on Pinedale or Maple Street, and seeing if they'd like to donate or volunteer their time to help out.
Well, my daughter lives on Pinedale, 16 Pinedale, and I walk her boxer down that trail fairly frequently, not all the time, but sometimes. And I think it's a great project. And I'd like to take the opportunity to donate all the materials for that sign personally. So give me a list and we'll get to stop.
All right, Al.
And also, if you have, you want to engrave the 2x8s or 2x10s, I'll do that. If you lay it out, I'll engrave them for you. One of the things that I have is a question on the Maple Street side of. I haven't been on the Maple Street side, but I have been on the Pinedale side. Is there actually a parking area on the Maple Street side?
There is no parking. A lot of people do park on, I forget what it's called. There's a small walking path with wood fences on either side that goes to Washington Park. And that goes from Riverside, and it goes out to a street connecting to Maple.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people walk through there. I know me and a few other people, when I went to graduate, we walked right through there for back and forth to school. There is no parking, but it is within walking distance of many places that do have parking. Washington Park and the train station are right there. So
the place that you're talking about putting the keystone, that was my question. Was there actually a parking area where you're talking
about?
It's
on Pinedale.
So
it's
not Maple Street. I'm sorry.
There is a parking area.
I thought you were talking about Maple Street.
Yeah. Well, Pinedale is a parking area. You probably get 3-4 cars in there if it was cleaned up.
Yeah.
But it is overgrown.
Right.
Dirt got into the old gravel there and started growing.
It's overgrown.
Yeah,
great project, Brian.
I agree. I got a couple quick things. Sometime last year, I think it was, the Reading Chronicle went out and did a piece on the fact that Pinedale needed some help, right? Needed cleaning up. So it might be a good idea to talk with them about coming out after you guys are done and showing that there's progress there. That would be a good way to get your advertising done. The other thing is, just as you're talking with your troop and whatnot, trimming some of the brush, there's invasive species all in there around that drive area, and then blazing the trails would be another good project for another scout, like to build on. It's nice when you commit to a few things and they make the place really nice. So just as you're talking with your fellow scouts, if someone else is looking for a project, that might be a good one to build off of. Hmm? It's just an idea.
Yeah.
I think he's very mature, more mature than me most days. That's great.
I was told that EWA projects especially, they have to be building something new.
Okay.
So that's why I'm incorporating the sign and the parking lot into mine. Trailblazing is just another part of it, because if it could have been another EWA project, I would have left it, offered it to somebody else. I know this year my troop is, we have a bunch of EWA projects going on, actually every weekend until next December.
Good. Good.
Good
stuff.
Just trailblazing can't count as an EWA project. It can be part of one, but so.
Good answer. All right.
I think this is a very worthwhile project, and
Well, one other thing that I just, as you were saying that, is the trees that were down across the some of the trails here. How are you proposing to cut those from the trail?
I know, I believe it's one or two of the scoutmasters, both have chainsaws, they're not familiar with the one. And again, it has already been sort of trying to get through it. It's like an axe or hatchet, they are halfway through.
Man, I think it's a great thing, because we were all out there last fall, and we all climbed over it and walked around it and jumped over it. And I had a safety concern, that's all. As to how that was going to take place, that's all. It really does need to be done, but
yeah.
I just was concerned about safety.
The only thing that I would add is that Ryan Percival, the town engineer, who's going to supply the three-quarter stone for the parking area and probably survey the Maple Street entrance, he wants to work with you on that. So I want you to come down to the office and kind of learn the procedures and kind of go through that yourself. And you probably have to meet the survey person out at Maple Street. So that's creating an entrance. So I'm sure that's an Eagle Scout project right there, because it doesn't exist now. I gave you his card, so you should be all set with that. But you should get a hold of him sooner rather than later. Okay. Thank you.
Any questions from the community? Hearing none? Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Being a little after 7:10, we have a minor land change, tree removal at 26 Smith Avenue.
23.
It says 26 there, it's 23.
Some of it was 26, some of it was 23. Yeah.
Timothy Brett, out of the 23 Smith Ave. We're previously approved to do an addition off the back of our existing house, and there are two trees here, 24 foot and 26 foot, which are within the 100 foot boundary. Some of the limbs hang pretty close to the wood, hang pretty close to the new structure, and they're fairly large trees. We'd like to remove those, just so those limbs aren't hanging over the house and the dirt, everything getting on the new addition.
We had a site visit on Tuesday.
Yesterday.
Yeah, and I guess the one that's off your property is a huge Norway spruce, and the one on your property on the line is a Norway maple.
Yeah.
They look fairly, I mean, they were alive,
So
I believe we would be looking at a replacement.
Okay.
According to our tree policy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think on the tree policy it said a replacement or a donation of, I forget how much, but. So the replacement, would that have to go within the 100 foot boundary?
Yes.
So we need to find an area to put two replacement trees.
We noticed there's still some trash right off the back of your property.
We had a landscaper come out and give us a quote. Well, I think we were scheduled to get it moved today, but I went by and it was not. Yeah. But we are going to move that before any construction.
Oh, okay. All right.
That's still part of the original.
Right.
Are you thinking of donating to the Shade Tree Fund? Because if you went that route, we would need to know that at some point, some prior to sign off.
Okay.
When the project's done, you'd have to show us that you had donated to that, because that's run by the town tree ward.
Okay.
Can I make that decision
this week?
Anytime, yeah. And just let us know.
Okay.
Well, the last question I have is on that, is that one of the trees is not on their property, so
would
that come half from them and half from the neighbor? One of the trees is not on their property.
Yeah, so we had a letter from the neighbor.
Given permission to cut it down.
Yeah.
Right, at the same time, but if they, if one donates, the other one doesn't, so you should stipulate as to how that's gonna work.
As long as they pay for two trees, we're looking.
I can do that, and I could just say that it's something in the minor plan change decision. I could just write something that he's gonna take care of both on each property.
So you got a letter from your next door neighbor?
Yes.
Do we have a copy of that?
It's in this, right here.
Oh, okay.
It's this big.
Yeah, it's 26 foot.
Wow, that's a pretty small letter, okay.
Yeah.
I retract my statement.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I forgot to mention that.
Okay.
So Mike, can I make a motion to approve the minor plan change?
Second.
All those in favor?
Thank you, and I'll let you know about the, what we plan to do, replacement or donation.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good luck.
So, we've got a few minutes.
Can you guys mind going over who approved and who seconded?
I made a motion.
Dave approved, I seconded.
Harry seconded.
Want to talk about the certificate of compliance at 310 South Street?
They're not coming in.
Right.
So we went to 310 South Street and we saw some inconsistencies with what we usually require to receive a certificate of compliance. I was, it was myself, Mr. Panette, and Ms. Longley. And we went to the site and noticed that first thing is the grass wasn't well established in certain areas, and it was a little sparse, and in some areas it almost seemed by the porch that was built, it didn't even seem to have any grass on it, and that's all within the 100-foot buffer zone. The second thing that we found was the 25-foot ZNV line, which is the zone of natural vegetation, was vegetated with grass. There would seem to be some room for some discussion with the owner or the contractor about that, and we missed each other a couple of times today on a phone call, but I did send them a list. So here's the ZNV right here, and it's all grass right up to where the erosion control is, just like that. And, you know, I understand the existing garage has been taken down, but we really need to know what was in this area prior to that. So that's what we're looking at to try to find out. The owner said that she would just need some direction from the commission, but I don't think it's as easy as saying, well, let's just fill up the 25-foot ZNV with native vegetation, because in some spots that takes so much of that lawn away, it doesn't really make it practical. So maybe a site visit if people wanted to be that involved, or you could allow me to work with the contractor to come up with something based on what was there existing and what was cleared and what they'll put back.
Can I ask a question about that? Because when we were out there and did the site visit, there was what appeared to be what was the original board of the existing lawn especially as it can, which it seemed to be contiguous with the neighbor's property. And as I'm looking at this here, it shows the existing garage is on the other side of the property line. Now, was there a change in the property lines at some point in time as part of this construction, or was the, where it says existing garage, was that always on
town
property?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, okay.
It was, and she said that in our phone call. She said, I know that we put the erosion control basically, you know, in the back, and that's
okay.
not our land. So she understands that.
Yeah.
I mean, it almost seems like, you know, Dave, you know, you get a good handle on this, maybe you should be involved, you know,
yeah.
moving forward also.
Did you mention the bituminous concrete underneath?
I did, and she came down and looked at it a couple of times, and she said she has no problem removing that.
Yeah.
So.
What about the conservation bounds? Are they going to pull those up out of the ground?
I'm not sure. I think the ones that would end up being in the grass area, the relief grass, should be flush,
yep.
so they can mow over them. But anything that would be outside of that should be at least 6 or whatever inches above the ground.
Okay.
I think you want to answer the question of the grass,
yep.
you know, a little before you start playing with the bounds.
Right.
What's the issue with having a tiny lawn? I don't, because it looks like it's teeny little spots outside of the inside of the 25 foot. It's two little corners. What am I missing?
It's hard to visualize it on that.
Yeah, and the line next door, it's very distinct. Right along, you know, what's natural vegetation, and I can't believe that these people had all the natural vegetation up here, and then there was a lawn down here. I just think
so
there would have been
you're,
more
you're
lawn.
Saying
I think there was lawn
insisting
there.
Insisting that every bit of that be revegetated with natural plants wouldn't be realistic. Is that what you're saying?
I think that's what the issue is, yeah. And I think
okay.
it needs to be resolved first, and then you can play with the bounds.
The knotweed that's there is going to take it over anyway.
I mean, clearly, you have every right to say town land.
Yep.
I mean, that's no question. That should be revegetated.
What's behind it?
It's like a forest.
It's a small stream.
Yeah. yeah.
Wetland area. You know, kind of a red maple swamp-ish type. No, there's a canopy.
Yeah.
I mean, what's there now other than the bituminous concrete? It looks okay. It's just that it doesn't, it's not in keeping with where the property line is.
Yeah. Okay.
So.
Okay. All right.
So this doesn't need to be continued. We're really just in the
right.
waiting process to wait for the grass and some of these other things to be resolved.
Mm-hmm. Okay, being a little after 7:20, we have a notice of intent 270-0684, 187 Bancroft Avenue, lot 27, map 308, Riley. And public hearing is now opened and being conducted concurrently under the authority of the Mass Wetlands Protection Act, Mass General Laws, Chapter 131, Section 40, as amended in the Reading General Bylaws, Section 7.1. Hearings conducted in the following manner. Applicant presents a proposal. Commission will receive reports from administrator, technical advisor, or other town departments. Commission will address questions and comments to the applicant. Then the public will be given the opportunity to ask questions of the applicant, and you should direct it to the chair. And when you do, give your name and address before your comments or questions are presented. At this time, I'd like to introduce members of the Conservation Commission, starting on my left.
Chuck Tironi, Conservation Administrator.
Al Couillard.
Rebecca Longley, Chair.
Harry Curtis.
David Panette.
Okay.
And my name is Jack Sullivan. I'm owner of the Sullivan Engineering Group, and I'm here on behalf of the owners, Tim and Erin Riley, and Tim's in the back row here tonight, if there's any questions, ma'am. Just to step the commission through this project, Tim and Erin have lived in this house for about 10 years. They have three small children. They love the neighborhood. They want to stay here, but in order to do so, they need to put on an addition to the house. They only have one existing bathroom, so they need some more space for their growing family. Norse Environmental flagged the wetlands, which were bank flags at the rear of the property. They're looking to put on an addition off the side of the house. There's no trees to be cut. There's only transitional site grading that's needed to match into the existing site grades. The construction entrance will be on the right-hand side of the property. You can see the existing paved driveways on the left. They won't be able to use that, but because they'd have to go behind the house and they have the in-ground pool in the back, so the construction entrance is on the right. And only a portion of this addition is within the 100-foot buffer zone. The closest point of the addition to the bank flags is 74 feet. There is an existing deck in the back that will be demolished to accommodate the addition. And to offer some stormwater mitigation, we're proposing a 1,000-gallon dry well with 12 inches of crushed stone surrounding to capture 515 square feet of roof area. And that equals about the extent of the addition within the 100-foot buffer zone. So it's relatively straightforward. It meets all aspects of zoning. The addition has to be at least 20 feet from the in-ground pool. I should say 10 feet from the in-ground pool, or 22 feet. All other areas, height setbacks, we meet, and we're well outside the 35-foot no structure zone. I'll turn it over to the commission for any questions that might have.
We had a site visit, and we're very disappointed that you're taking out those two decks. We really like those.
I love the decks.
I know. That was nice. I'm sorry. And it is pretty straightforward. We did notice to the left and in back along the natural vegetation, there is some twigs and leaf litter that, you know, during your construction, we'd really appreciate that you remove that. Any other comments from the commission members that, Dave?
Looks straightforward. I think you should move those decks over to the right-hand side of the pool.
We'll find a way.
Yeah.
Bring them to my yard. Chuck, do you have any comments?
No, I don't. I would say that don't get their, you know, a different idea. The yard scraps and the leaf and the twigs and things like that, it was, I would call it an extensive pile, so it's not, and we would add this into the order and be checking it to make sure it gets done. It looks like you do have access. I mean, man, you've made that your yard just work. I mean, you have a lot of stuff there, but it all works well. But I think there's an area between the shed and the fence that you could probably walk in and grab that and bring it out.
Yeah, we'll get rid of that.
I think there was a gate right there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are there any comments from the community? Hearing none.
I make a motion to approve it as is.
Second.
All those in favor?
Thank
you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
So you'll do the order next meeting?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
So we'll close at the next meeting, right?
Close it now. Who did you?
We approved.
You approved. Yeah. So we'll issue it at the next meeting.
Right.
Okay. So Tim and I do not have to be there.
No.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I think Mike wasn't here for that.
Why?
Because if you do it in the wrong order, Mike yells at you.
Oh, yeah. All right. We've got one more minute.
Did we get a...
Yes.
...official ruling or something?
No.
From the DEP?
No, we don't have a superseding order, I don't believe. Is that what we would get? Yeah, no.
Well, still grabbing this
one. We're waiting for Haskell.
Right, okay.
Being 7:30, do We have a minor plan change for 270-0676 Zero Low Meadow off Acadia, Haskell. And we have a new plan presented or sent to us from Norse Environmental based on the site visit on April 19th, 2017 with Mass DEP Mike Abel. And
yeah, and that's what I'm bringing up here. I'm showing everyone that the revisions incorporates the DEP comments, and you can see that right down at the bottom, and it's dated 5/8/2017. So the revisions asked for was curbing along the eastern edge of the driveway, infiltration trench or equivalent at the bottom of the driveway, and then to modify the construction plans to use sod for stabilizing the southern property edge if grass is not established by late in the season, and that's October. So that's what DEP asked for. It'll come to us in a more official way, but we're just synchronizing our order of conditions with the superseding order of conditions that we expect to be sent to us anytime, but they still have 60 days.
I looked at this today, and was the temporary gravel construction entrance exit pad on the original?
Yeah, well, it was on a revision. I actually asked for that.
Okay.
It was presented in one of the meetings. I don't believe it was on the, it wasn't
the original
plan.
One. Okay.
No.
Yeah.
So is this a new 1,000-gallon
yes.
dry well to the right of the driveway?
Yeah.
And that's where the trench drains into?
Yeah. The trench drain at the bottom of the driveway is going to drain into that.
And then the curb between the neighbors, is that right at the up the side of the driveway?
Yes.
Okay.
As you look at it, facing the house, it's to the right.
Oh, and proposed that, Cape Cod berm.
Cape Cod berm is
yep.
The detail is over here.
Questions from Chuck? Any comments, questions?
I don't have any comments on this.
Okay.
This is more administrative,
okay.
syncing it up with what DEP asked for.
Mr. Rauch, did you take, were you able to look at this plan?
I have. I'd like to have a hard copy. I couldn't get it off the computer.
Oh.
But other than that, yeah, I really don't have any comments. Mm-hmm. You know, we asked for, we got most of what we asked for, so.
All right. Do I hear a motion?
Oh, thank you, sir.
Motion to approve the minor plan
thank
change.
Thank you,
270-0676 Low Meadow, Haskell.
A second.
All those in favor? Thank you.
Good.
Thank you. What's my name? Bye-bye. Wow. Okay. Moving right along. Certificate of compliance for, can we do Strawberry Hill Lane?
Yes.
Chuck?
If you have time. Yeah.
Yep. I had some comments. I was able to review it, and it was just, you know, getting the Latin names done correctly, you know, periods. All it was consistency, truthfully. I don't need to go over it.
Yeah. I did have one question, one comment on this, and it was about the bond. You have 3 years on the bond. Why is it 3 years? I thought that basically it was 2 years, and that was for the growth season of the vegetation.
Well, it can be anything. It can be 10 years, but I have been telling you guys over the last couple of orders of conditions, I'm putting things in that area, but it's not, it's up to you to change them. I mean, I'm kind of highlighting them somehow. 3 years, you know, 3 years is not over the top, but usually it's 2 years when you plant.
Yeah.
And 3 years when you're removing invasive vegetation.
Yeah.
So.
And at this point, they're not removing.
I asked
invasive,
for a
right?
bond of $7,000. I thought that was something that we just should discuss, because the only reason why this is going through is because of all those, all that planting.
Right.
So it's very important that it gets done. And when the building is done, we have a bond or a surety on that of $20,000, but that goes away as soon as we do the certificate of compliance, which we
right.
probably will do before the pool is completed.
And that goes to the builder.
So I wanted something.
The only thing is that if it's going to be growing, I think it would be growing within 2 years, and it's, when I looked at it, I just thought it's.
I got a call just the other day, and the homeowner has to take care of this himself because we're outside the 2 year window, which was 1261 Main Street, and there's arborvitae that run between the properties, not along the road, runs from the road back into the woods. He said half of those are dead. And that happened, that was 2014. So when I was talking to...
across the street from Veterans Way.
Talked to Bob Keating and asked him why he thought they might have died, and he said it was just watering, but the homeowner said he watered them.
He
watered them every day,
yeah.
Or a lot.
There was no winning last year.
No, there wasn't any winning. Last year was an extraordinary year.
So you can see what you're doing is, and this is just the homeowner, I guess, and they're not going to sell it. But if it was a contractor, just what happened on 1260, you might really want to guarantee that they survive and you don't pass that burden on to the homeowner. I think 2 years is sufficient, personally, but
it says
you never
three,
know.
It says 3 years on the order of conditions for 16 Strawberry Hill Lane. That was my question. It's 3 years for the bond, for 16 Strawberry Hill. That was the only thing that I picked up.
Are you asking to change that, or are you asking just for clarification on that?
Clarification on it, that's all. Because we had been doing 2 years before, and I just wondered why it was 3 years. Because the 16 Strawberry Hill.
So, the way I read that last A4 is that after we issue the certificate of compliance, so if they got the planting in early, and if you're going to plant it in the spring, that's the clock.
Right.
But if you plant it in the fall, you have to wait till the following spring to start that first year.
Okay.
So, if they plant early, and it's in for those 2 years, and we're questioning it, we can hold up, we have a 3 year window to hold up to 50% of the bond, but we don't have to.
Okay.
That's just once we sign off on everything. You can hold back $100 if you wanted to. It's up to us.
So the applicant actually after 2 years could ask for 50% of their bond back?
They can ask for I expect them to ask for all of it back and for the commission to get into a discussion, because I'll bring it up. I'll say that does anyone think that they need to hold back some money on this bond?
I'm okay with it as written. I just had a question on it just for clarification, that's all.
Okay.
I would be okay with a smaller bond, because I don't see all the plants dying at once. But I thought what you did was fine.
There's usually, the plants that are important to me are the ones closest to the, the pond area.
Yep.
And I think they created a great little.
I saw that. Wow.
So
I drove by that. There were four police cars.
Some sort of pipe bomb that somewhere out is going on here.
Drove by that, and I thought there were so many. Right at kind of across the street for the school a little bit closer towards Main Street. There's a side street. I think actually Camille Anthony lives on that street. But there were four police cars, and they were surrounding something. There was a gentleman out in the street. But I thought there was an awful lot of cars there.
No, I saw them all going there when I got off the train.
Yeah.
Was there an ambulance, too?
I didn't see an ambulance, no.
They all went tearing down the street.
Wow. Yeah, to get back to Harry's point, I think that Chuck knows it. I'm not a big fan of the bonds. I think $7,000 is
substantial. It's just like kind of a lot of money for
this. Substantial amount of money.
Smokes.
Especially with all the other power this board can, all the other avenues this board has that brings someone into compliance. So maybe, I would support some, maybe 50% of that, I think would be adequate.
Yeah, I agree.
Just one man's opinion.
I'd go with 4,000.
What do you think, Dave?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would die. My initial inclination was a 5,000 bond for 2 years, and at some point in time you could ask for a portion of that back, but you know, that's up to the commission to decide. It is an individual homeowner. It's not like a contractor that you can hold over the fire.
Yeah,
it's building four houses.
You're not supposed to talk like that, you know.
No.
I don't know. Sounds like for a single family building, I'll give it to you, Chuck. There is a lot of plantings here, and they are important plantings, especially to abutters.
I think they're important to the homeowner too.
Yeah.
I mean, if the number is 4, 5, 3.5, whatever, it's just important to have that ability. I mean, you're right. We don't usually do this on homeowners. But
it's a lot of trees.
It's a lot of trees, and it's the reason why this project's going through. So, yeah, two important things. Plus, we lose the other one. I mean, I don't know of a way to keep some of someone else's bond on.
The other thing I would take into consideration here is that we're working with a really cooperative homeowner, I think, who wants to do the right thing. So you should prepare for the worst, but I think they're going to cooperate with some trees down there. They're going to replace the trees as well as after they invoke a bond, but go anywhere near that. But do we need to decide that number tonight? Or?
Yeah, I'd like a number.
I'll stick with 35, but.
Do I hear 4,000? 4,000.
I'm okay with 35.
I'm okay with the 3,500.
Did I just say 35,000?
35,000? That's crazy.
Yeah, right.
Sorry.
All right.
That's only
if
Al
Kugas. That's only if Al's doing those.
Okay, 35 it is.
All right, thank you.
Do we need to vote on this?
Vote to issue as amended.
Do I hear?
Sure. I make a motion to approve. Where is it? Are we approving the NOI, or are we issuing a certificate?
Certificate.
In the old and new order business, bottom.
14 Strawberry Hill Lane.
I make a motion to approve the certificate of compliance 270-0681 14 Strawberry Hill Lane as amended.
Second.
All those in favor?
Great.
Are we all?
Here we go.
Six Woodland Street for the trees tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I just tried to get through things that I thought would be quicker so we can keep on schedule. Being a little after 7:40, we have a continued RDA for 2017-1 Lot B, Zero Border Road, Map 6, Lot 4, Hanson. Family Nominee Trust continued to this evening's meeting, and I see the applicants are here.
So following the Conservation Commission meeting in April, when we met with you, and the subsequent site visit by Mr. Coulard. And
Coulard, yeah.
Coulard,
yeah.
Charles. The recommendation was made that we hire a consulting engineer to represent us and somebody who understood the regulations in town, and I think the comment was spoke the language of the Conservation Commission. So we reached out to Jeffrey Brim of Meisner Brim Corporation and made arrangements with Jeffrey to meet us at the site, evaluate the lot, and look at the water path that was on the lot. So Jeffrey came out on the 19th, which was last Friday, met with us at the site. However, prior to Jeffrey's arrival, the town highway commission department came out to service the culvert on Two Border Road, and they cleared the brook. They raked the brook and cleared the debris out of the brook.
On your side of the property?
The whole thing, right up to Route 93.
Oh.
So Jeffrey looked at it and said, there's really not much I can tell you about the brook. It's running fine. It's doing what it's supposed to do. And he's going to work with us on the rest of the lot to look at the wetlands, you know, the wetland plan on the lot and see if it's a buildable lot and talk about going forward there. But, yeah, we, as a matter of fact, we happened to be there that day, and we looked out, and I assume that's the highway department truck. They were there clearing it out.
Do you have any of them with a rake standing in the stream?
I happen to.
Oh, Chuck's going to go get someone in trouble.
In fact, Jeffrey said, why do you need me? And we said, well, when we called you, it was debris in the stream.
I mean, I know that person.
Oh, boy. Luckily, we were there, because if we had not been, we wouldn't have any idea how that got cleared out.
We would have blamed you.
We said that. We said, and we would have no defense, because we have no idea how that happened.
We were working on Two Border Road, doing some cleaning.
Yeah.
And I guess you looked out to bring something down the backyard, and two people over there.
There's a guy in an orange, bright orange hoodie as well.
Did you ask him what they were doing?
Well, yeah. By that time they were almost finished.
Yeah, they were up at, they were right at the 93. They said they weren't going to go over the over that fence.
The right of way fence.
Property, but they're going to go up to the fence and clear that. They said that they have problems with water backing up on the other side as well, and they have problems with the culvert, so they are trying to keep the water flowing. So.
And he said that a lot had jammed up in front of the culvert. That's what alerted him to the fact that it was jamming up because so much was coming down.
In fact, he said the culvert really needs to be rebuilt. It's collapsing.
Yeah, when we looked at that culvert, it was not in good shape at all.
No,
it was mostly covered.
Can you move this back?
Yeah.
Oh, before you take them out, I'm gonna get a copy.
Our intent is not to get him into trouble. You know, that just
that ship sailed.
Well, he said they were going around town and clearing areas that were flooding, and he had driven down and saw that, and knew that there had been a problem there, and he saw the debris coming down. And that's why they were cleaning it.
Have you had any conversation at all with Mass Highway regarding culvert that goes?
No, in fact, I have actually reached out to the people who are working on West Street, and I'll get back to them and find out. I'll check with the managers down there to see if they can direct me the correct way, because DOT guys are tenants down there. And so I can check with them and check further.
What specifically do you think?
Well, whether they've done any investigations as to what condition the culvert that goes from one side of the highway right away to the other, what condition it's in, whether it's got any debris that's clogging it,
yeah,
or any other. Is there any blockage that's causing flooding on the uphill side of that?
Well, we did meet with the Town of Reading Engineering Department after we met with you, Charlie, and they said that they were concerned about that culvert, but they didn't want to do anything that would make them responsible for the culvert.
The Highway Department.
The Town of Reading didn't.
Yeah, right, they can't.
They can't, really.
High pressure, some kind of a high pressure flush would be good, but they were not going to do that.
Yeah, it's the highway right of way, it's not the town right of way.
Right.
But apparently they were thinking of that because they've got water problems backing up prior to that. And this gentleman was aware of that, and he said that this is part of the problem, the whole thing backing up.
He said he's responsible for the streams not flooding, but he has to clear them so that they won't flood.
I wonder how many other streams he cleared.
Is there a...
You know, it's a tricky little tightrope you walk on. I mean,
right.
You can't have it flood, but you really can't alter the resource area. And these guys are out there, and their focus is to prevent flooding. Now, I don't know what it looks like. Jimmy said, what's his name? Jeffrey said it was running fine. That doesn't mean all the broken up leaf biomatter and all that has been removed. Maybe it has, I'm not sure, but if it was like sand on the bottom, because I saw more of a muddy looking leafy area, then that would be a problem. But if it's just sticks and he's pulling out of there, I don't know. It's not okay, but I guess that was what I would say if I was a
DPW
balancer.
As long as they don't clear out every stream all the way to its source.
Well, no, I think that we're gonna have a conversation tomorrow and find out what's going on, and then that's. I mean, this. To me, all the ones that I know about that they actually really do some work on, and if they want to do some violations, why don't we start at the list that's really bad, that really floods people? And this one was just walkable. This is crazy. I mean, it's so flat. If it flooded out, it only would have just kind of still gone in the same spot, but just spread out a little bit. But we'll see. So Jeffrey Brim. He's worked here before. He did a project up the street.
Yeah.
Did a good job. I know he's from Littleton or Westford.
He's from Littleton and I think Salem, New Hampshire. But we just received his proposal for the evaluation. He has a botanist and so forth that he'll bring in from the site.
Yeah, that's great.
Is he an
engineer? Is he the
No, he's an environmental scientist. He may also be an engineer.
He's a registered engineer. I don't know what his expertise is. He's a PE.
Okay. All right.
So what's still shelving this? Are we going to continue? This is not. This is.
Well, we
want to just take it off the agenda and let him refile when he's ready.
Yeah.
Well, let's. With an RDA.
With an RDA, we're looking at where. Well, what are we looking at in this? Are we looking at the location of the resource area?
So the RDA asks two questions: is the work proposed in the resource area or in the buffer zone? And the answer to that is, of course, yes. And then, is the work proposed likely to alter the resource area or the buffer zone? And after hearing what we're talking about here, you guys have to make that decision whether it's likely to alter. And I mean, you could go down that path and close this out and let Jeffrey come in and kind of work with that. That we said that this. Determination is a positive determination, meaning that you need to file a notice of intent for any work that you want to do from here forward. So that's really all it does. Or you could just leave it open and let
Yeah, keep it open and let them.
Let figure out how he wants to.
Get some advice from your consultant about the best way to go, and we'll listen to what he has to say.
Just with that, so we request for them to withdraw.
So, okay, yeah, that works. Yeah, that it's fine. But he's not. He can't. Whatever they're doing, they can't use this. Because I think those two questions are pretty clear. I mean, I can't give the answer to the second one, but I know it, just like I think most people do. So that can't go any other way. But let's want to continue it for a couple of weeks. And do you know what time he might be available?
He said is that it would take,
I thought he said 3 weeks or more.
We just got this today, so.
You haven't even had a chance to read it yet.
Yeah. And of course, now his focus is on evaluating the lot to establish if it's a buildable.
So why don't we just continue it to the next meeting? I'll call Jeffrey and see what he wants to do. If there's anybody. But this is our decision. It's not their decision.
Well, can I ask you, is it your intent that you're looking to build on the other side of this stream, if you will, on the opposite side from your parents' house?
We're not looking to build out at this point. We're going to be selling the house, and the intent was that we would offer the lot at the same time that we sold the house. And as Jeffrey said, it may make sense to establish that it's a buildable lot before we put the property on the market, which makes sense. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And we looked at the access, and it's about 38 feet of access on the road, and there's a fair amount of land on the right rear corner of the property that, according to Jeffrey, the type of trees and growth are not typical of wetlands. So he said, you know, it's quite likely that it is, but he hasn't established that yet.
What's the requirement for frontage in that area?
I don't know.
Yes, 15, right? 100 feet. 100 feet.
Do you have to go through that problem? I know that when those lots were subdivided, there are three lots. They were done with the intent that there would be three buildable house lots. So presumably they have the front. Because they could have moved that
140
foot of frontage on Porter Road.
Right.
For the entire lot?
No, this is just that.
Well, yes, for that particular lot.
Oh, okay. All right. This is the one that has the house on it right now?
Yeah, this one has the house on it.
And this is the, so the stream kind of comes across this way?
Yeah, it comes across.
Okay. All right.
It actually comes more onto this lot than we realized, and then it comes across and continues.
Okay.
And it's 38 feet of frontage here from the stream.
Is that on our end or
the other? No, it's on the other end. A portion of the stream is actually on Zero Border Road.
Okay. So we're just tabling this.
I think we probably want to get to a point where we can get this out of the way by the next meeting. But it sounds like some of the commission members want to make sure that that's what their consultant wants. So I was going to call him between meetings and just say we'd like to dispose of this because it's going to be a positive determination. Does he need this vehicle to move forward? And I don't think he does.
Okay. All right.
That's fine.
All right.
So you'll reach out to Jeffrey?
Yeah. I will.
I mean, we will too because we have to work a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the next meeting we attend should be after?
We're going to have you on the next meeting. And I have your information too. I'll call you and you can decide whether you want to come in or not at our next meeting.
That's 2 weeks from now, so they would not have had time to do any of this work.
Right, but it's not about what he's doing. It's about this request for determination that you wanted to do. I don't think he's going to be able to establish a buildable lot using a request for determination of applicability, right? Because you probably want to have it recorded. And you don't usually do that with a request for determination.
Okay.
So that's it. But I'll just walk it through with Mr. Berman and we'll see what he says, and I'll keep everybody informed. And he'll probably, like I said, I'll talk to him, he'll talk to you guys, I'll talk to the commission.
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay.
tree policy, 6 Woodland Street, Larson Wilson.
Once again.
We took a look, we did a site visit on Tuesday. Straightforward.
I don't see a buffer zone in this plan.
You'd almost consider it kind of a wet area.
I would.
It's
very scientific, Chuck.
Well, he's asking where the buffer zone is, and I'm saying it's probably a wet area. So the buffer zone is probably closer to the shed and starting closer to the shed, driveway, and house. It's wet underneath the trees, and where it says parcel 56, but not running water, or open water.
There's a small swale over here.
Yeah.
Coming off of Hanscom.
So is there? I'm sorry, I can't get to these on a Tuesday. But is it lawn?
No.
It's kind of a forested area. Didn't have much leaf litter on it, but it had a lot of cinnamon fern, and it had some princess fern, and it had buttress root trees. I mean, the trees that he chose to take down, I mean, every single one of them, you know, Dave was telling us everything about all of them. Everything had a high level of probability that a problem could happen. So one of them was a triple or quadruple trunk, and it was growing on a huge, 2 or 3 huge rocks. So it must be very rocky soil down there. But you guys can discuss it, but I'll tell you, my observation was this was the first person that looked at the tree policy and really put together what we need to move forward. I really liked his narrative, the plants that he chose, and the plan we were able to. The only thing I would have said was it would have been a little bit easier if each tree that was coming down had a little ribbon around it so we could quickly spot those. But other than that, I just really liked the presentation I got, and I didn't even give them much direction. So this was all about reading it.
Oh, it read like you coached them all through it. It's really good.
I think this is a testament to the
quality of the tree policy.
The quality of the tree policy.
I think you're right.
Who was on that committee?
Mostly.
I don't know. I forget.
Kanika started it, right?
Yeah, Alan and Anika.
Alan, yeah, that sounds like a little Alan and Anika.
Rock band.
Yeah.
All right. So what officially is this, Chuck? It's a request to cut trees.
It's completely under the shade tree policy.
It's like a minor project.
We don't actually have a name for it, but it's tongue hauling at our shade tree policy, and this is a more than 1-to-1 replacement of native shrubs, and they identified the fact that some of these things are diseased and
dead or dying.
I guess they're going to have like their craters in them, and they're growing on top of rocks. So each one of them, not every single one of them, but for the most part, they fit in a couple of different ways. Not only through the replacement of each tree, but through the fact that there was issues with them.
So what's the mechanism for us to we just take a vote and approve?
I think we
says this?
Well, I think you would accept it if you think it qualifies.
Well, make
I
a motion
it
to
qualifies.
I make a motion to accept the
second
proposal.
All those in favor?
All right.
Okay.
John, they just said the people need some family. They said that there's 38 feet between the edge of the stream and the edge of the property bow. That's going to be a third problem with the driveway? Any kind of driveway that they try and put in there?
I don't know.
That's why you hire a consultant.
Yeah, I want to find out about that. Not about what you're talking about, but I'm curious about.
The DPW
folks. Jeff?
Yeah, it's
really nice to have a picture after all these years. I think that's the best.
You should put a wanted poster up at town hall before they come in the morning.
I understand how difficult that job is, and I don't know what happens.
It's a teachable moment.
They say the road to where is paved with good intentions.
I save all the tree in that for Anika when she's here. That would have been 25 minutes on do's and don'ts.
You know, she reviews the minutes. I mean, she reviews these meetings, Chuck.
Oh, and speaking of that, can we approve these minutes?
I make a motion to approve all minutes.
You want to look? These are, Rebecca looked at them and made some changes. She came in early to do that, but it's going to get two off the list.
Okay, that looks good.
These are all copies. These are my comments. Okay?
I was just doing that for fun anyway.
And then, okay. Here's the other one, and these are my comments.
What's the date of these minutes we're looking at, Chuck?
It's the first two, 4/26/17 and 5/10/17.
So we don't have anything to sign?
We do not. We just make a vote.
Do I hear a motion?
Make a motion to approve the minutes from 4/26/17 and 5/10/17.
As amended.
Second.
All those in favor? Okay.
We have material for 348 South Street that's not on the agenda. Did that come with the package and then it didn't get added, or?
348 South Street. I'm drawing a blank.
We did 310 South Street.
310?
We did 310. We did that.
We did 310.
Certificate of compliance?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. It's 310 South.
That was the one.
I'm sorry. It's got both addresses on here.
She lives up the street.
Okay. All right. I'm sorry.
Yep.
Got it.
Okay. I want to talk about Carriage Lane, or do you want to talk about Main Street?
I'll talk about, what, did 306 Main Street?
World.
Yeah, I don't think that needs to, that's in the process. I can update you on two projects, all right? So Carriage Lane has really come together. So I don't have much to say because they've hired a consultant. Three families have hired a consultant to come up with a plan to kind of correct that situation and turn, you know, lemons into lemonade. So I don't want to, you know, tell you anything, but we'll be getting an application to, or probably notice of intent for each individual house, and they'll move forward. But what had happened was someone misunderstood his buffer zone line, and the neighbors took advantage of what they thought was an opening and did some cutting, and but realized their mistake and are willing to do something about repairing it. So they've hired Tom Hughes to put together a planting plan, and they're working with him right now. But Tom has to figure out where the wetland line is. He has to come up with three planting plans, some sketches and whatnot. I did let them know that for me, I wasn't interested in having engineered, surveyed plans, because I'd prefer that money to go into plants and trees and whatnot, and it just seemed something that we didn't need. So that would keep the price down of presenting this. So it's in Tom's hands. Did I skip anything? I know that I know more about it than you guys, and maybe you're still in the dark. So if you have any questions, you can ask me.
No questions.
310 South Street, 306 Main Street is in the process of turning over between buyers. And I don't think this is the one you meant. Do you mean Perfecto's?
No, I'm talking about, we talked about Pizza World.
Yeah.
The
so,
planting and the two orders of conditions.
But he's, so the owner is juggling several ideas to try to close out his project.
That's crazy.
So he hasn't chose which one he did, but he did discover that there's some open orders of conditions on his property. Three. One of them is so old, we're not going to worry about. One of them has to do with the oil spill that asks for some planting that would need to be done before we close that out. So he's trying to figure out how he's going to manage that and sell the property. He's kind of juggling that right now and trying to find out what's happening and what the new owner will buy, will do, and what the new owner won't do. So, but, you know, I don't want to give away anything for Brandon. So I mean, I think that's about all I would say. He hasn't chose anything. He has at least three options to do. Okay, I talked to you about one of them, if it comes up, but he might not choose that.
This is the new owner, right?
No, this is Brandon. This is like super
Brandon?
Confusing. I mean,
it is.
Yeah. Why am I gonna do this on TV? I mean, my God.
That's okay, fine.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
Let's let him choose one, whichever he's doing, and then, like I said to you on the phone, then they can present it, or his lawyer will present it to us.
Okay.
And it's clear to me, but I think you just understand it a little bit better than, because he was talking to me as he was kind of developing this thought.
To talk, but not say anything.
I just don't want to talk about it.
Are the order conditions existing on the property holding up to closing for the new owner? Oh.
Yeah. The new owner shouldn't buy, you shouldn't buy a piece of property with an open order of conditions on it if all the work is done.
Mm.
You need a certificate of compliance, and we've seen people come in and do this all the time. So, there's a planting plan that wasn't completed. And they're trying to figure out how to manage that. So, and it needs to be completed by somebody. One or the other needs to take on the responsibility, and that's going to be a 2-year responsibility for that planting plan. So.
Well, that order of conditions runs concurrently with the title of the property. So if it changed hands, the new owner doesn't have a choice. He automatically is obligated to fulfill the conditions.
The new owner wants the... So
yeah,
the,
he wants the other guy to do it. I get it, but
the one that
don't care.
He wants closed
it,
off is the one that has to do with the oil spill. The oil spill asks for
a lot
of stuff.
Yeah.
Most of it's
yeah.
done and planting, and he wants that off the table, and he wants to take on only the order of conditions that allows the building of the structure and, you know, landscaping and all that. So it's more understandable and clean.
Yep, I get it.
So,
Perfectos.
Perfectos. I mean, can I say Perfectos? Let me just say Perfectos. Mr. Pouliot would be pleased to go down there and look at that stream.
I've been seeing the work on it. I didn't pull in, but I saw them order extra logs and... I saw some workers over there, some activity.
They got that thing. they somehow turned that into what it's supposed to look like.
Really? Good for
yeah.
them. Good.
Really, really nice. It was like, I don't know, 65% complete, but if they just mimic what they did on the front half to the back half, you know, really, really
good. They got those logs up in there on the bank? And,
they
yeah.
staked them in. The channel seems to be wide enough to manage.
Oh, nice.
Not only do they stake them, they rebar all that.
They've put down some matting and they've stapled that in, they've overseeded, and then they're cutting it open and putting in ferns and other plants that are called on that on the plant list.
Really?
Yeah, so it's and they actually had some. I think they are getting serious. They really probably would like to be
open.
Yeah, I don't know. Do you flip bagels or do you just drain them? I don't know. Take them out of the water. Whatever they want to do, they want to stop flipping bagels. Yeah. So.
But I mean, they should be doing that for. I mean, I'd have some concerns about the corner of that building eventually.
No. They're
going to erode.
They were able to get the core logs as close as they could, and then what they did is they just filled in that area, so it's actually very protected
nice.
Now.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, it's not as close as it used to be. So,
that's good.
I was there with Dave, and I was there with Becky, and I think we all agreed that it was,
job well done.
Surprising. I don't know.
from the back corner,
it was good.
Of the building to the stream bed is probably at least 2 feet.
Okay.
So it's substantially wider than it ever was. So it's much, much better than it was last fall.
Yeah.
The first time Harry and I went up there, I was like, oh my God.
That was bad.
Oh, and they took all the rocks off the back, so all those boulders and all that riprap, that's all gone, and that's has the matting on it that's seeded, and they're hoping that seed established back there. Yeah, but it looks a lot better. You know, it looks, I'm gonna say manageable. That one corner that you know about, it's still steep.
Yeah.
It's still a good drop there, but there's nothing you can do about that. And they'll just have to get something to grow there. Hold that back.
Okay, good. Good news. All right.
I think we are.
Any motion to
adjourn? Make a motion to adjourn.
Okay.
All those in favor?
It's still light out.